Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and in this video I'm going to discuss about traction motor selectivity, one of the most important questions I have been facing quite a lot of time. Like the induction motors and the DC series motor, both of these are traction motors. Then what makes one to be selected for one purpose and another not to be selected for that purpose? So in this video, I am going to clear all the doubts regarding which traction motor is suitable for which purpose. So first of all, we come to DC series motor. One of the most prominent examples of traction is the railways. And DC series motors have been serving railways since a very long time. So let's see what makes it really good for that purpose. So DC series motor, as the name says, has the field like this and the armature. Sorry for my bad drawing again. Anyway, so this is the armature and that is the field, and both of these are connected something like this in series. So here we give the DC supply, here is the field flux is generated and the armature flux is generated, both react to each other and the torque is generated, and that makes the motor to rotate. Now the interesting part is that the field produces magnetic field lines because of the current passing through it, and eventually the current passing through the field and the armature is the same. Okay, so the field current is equal to the armature current. Now the magnetic field flux is directly proportional to the current passing through it. So if I say that the current is I, then the armature current is also I, and hence the torque is dependent on the square of this current, because the torque is dependent on product of armature current and the magnetic field flux. And because of these all relations, we can conclude that the motor torque is dependent on the square of armature current. Now what is interesting about that? The first thing we can see from this relation, that even for a small amount of current, we can have a very great torque. Actually, if I draw a torque speed character, sorry, torque current characteristic actually, and if torque is in this direction and the current is in this direction, we will be getting a graph all the way from zero to this. Okay, so this is the characteristic of a DC series motor. So you can see that even for a small amount of current, we are getting a huge amount of torque, until and unless the motor gets saturated, the field gets saturated, right? Now the second thing about this, from the relation we can see the torque is directly proportional to square of the current, which means it doesn't depend on the polarity of current. So even if I supply it with an AC voltage, I will be getting the same unidirectional torque, I will be getting the positive torque, and hence these motors are also known as universal motors, right? So if you come across some topic like universal motor, always remember DC series motor is one of the best examples of universal motors. We need some changes in the design, of course, but still we can use it as a AC motor as well. Now coming to the disadvantages, we saw that the torque is good and it can be supplied through AC and DC both, but there are certain limitations. The first thing, any DC motor is not good and not suitable for noisy environment. So DC series motors cannot operate in that environment, and even if operate, the efficiency will go down. The second thing is that the DC series motors or any DC motors have brushes, which means that the stationary part and the rotating part is not isolated from each other, and because of this brush contact, there is always constant sparking going on here and in here. So because of this sparking, there is a huge amount of power loss in form of heat, and not only that, these brushes wear out, and wearing out of these brushes may make the motor unoperable for quite a lot amount of time. So these two things are really important. And talking about the speed control ability, well, DC series motors have a very good speed control ability, and it's very easy to control the speed of such motors. Okay, so that is not a costly, and DC series motors are good for small operations, for operations of railways, of suburban or urban services, where the train does not have to go for very long distances, and has frequent stoppages. Now we will come to induction motors. No introduction needed for induction motors. Induction motors are one of the most efficient motors we have. The reason for efficiency is that the stator and the rotor is not connected with any physical wire or anything. There is only magnetic coupling between the both. Okay, both of these are magnetically coupled. There are some windings on the stator like this. I am just making a representative diagram. No need of any real life. So this is how it goes. We give AC supply. If we consider the case of a three-phase AC motor, the three phases are given to the stator, and eventually they create a rotating magnetic field, if you know by the theory. This rotating magnetic field is being cut by the rotor conductors. They generate EMF, and as these are short-circuited, the rotor conductors are short-circuited, so a current flows through them and they produce their own magnetic field. These both magnetic field react to each other and the induction motor begins to rotate. And as there is no physical connection, the motor is very much efficient. And not only this, for the same kilowatt rating as that of a DC motor, these motors have a huge amount of speed. Now that is another disadvantage of this, that because of such enormous speed, the speed control technologies are really complex and costly. We use VVVFD, that is variable voltage variable frequency drives. Okay, what they do, this VVVFD drives, actually they make the ratio of V is to F such that the flux remains constant, the magnetic field flux within the motor remains constant. And by varying this, we can actually control the torque, speed and all those things. So this technology is really costly compared to that of a DC series motor. Now apart from that, there are no such disadvantage of using these motors. These are costly than DC series motors, of course, for the same operation. But for long distances, DC series motors are not that efficient like these of induction motors. And that's why you will see that most of the high speed trains, which have to travel all the way from one place to another, covering a whole lot amount of distance, they use induction motors instead of DC series motors. So these are the parameters on which traction motors are selected. So thanks for watching, and I hope you have liked this video. If you have liked this video, please like, comment, share and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to stay updated. This is Vivek Choubey signing off. Thank you.